Joining us now, over at the social media wall and making her late night MASH debut, please welcome my very dear friend, Rosie Jones!
Kumar!
Jonesy!
You taught your town booking me! Jesus!
Do you think I booked the show myself?
Yes! You've only got friends because you pay yours.
I'm genuinely worried about this.
You're the fuck. Daddy's talking. I'm Daddy. Right, I'm here to talk about people like me. And by me, I don't mean top-class legends with their banging rock. Anyway, I'm here to talk about disabled people! Yeah! Right. Being disabled isn't just about getting to piss in the big loo. I can piss anywhere. And I do. Living with a disability in the UK in 2021 is bloody hard. And not just because so-called friends like Nish, Kumar insists on going round pushing over innocent disabled people. Look! 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 Look!
No, what happens is that when we're in public together, she throws herself on the floor and shouts, help, help, the man from the MASH pushed a disabled girl.
Fish! Why would I do that? Do you believe a lovely little disabled lady or that prick? But from one enemy to another, last week the bloody government released a new plan to fix health and social care and called it Build Back Better. It's a plan to fix social care and been hugely criticised by disabled people's organisations for ignoring disabled care users and failing to address systemic issues such as staff shortages. This plan to fix social care has been hugely criticised by disabled people's organisations for ignoring disabled care users. I don't know why we trust the Tories to make this legislation when we all know they have absolutely no fucking clue. The Tories tried to justify the removal of essential support by claiming that it helped improve independence. That's like the proverb about giving a man a fish. It works unless that man has no arms, no fishing rod, and lives in the desert. If you teach that man to fish, you killed him. Just give him a fucking fish. And then how they assess your benefits is ludicrous. A stranger comes into your house for 10 minutes, has a look at you and makes a decision that affects the rest of your life. I mean, sometimes a snap judgment is accurate. Dickhead. That's a way to plan to fix social care. Reads like not a single disabled person was involved in it. How on earth are we ever going to make change if our fates are decided for us by a bunch of cretins who wouldn't know a group of disabled people even if we ram-raided Parliament with our scooters, frames and chairs, which I'm not suggesting. But I am free on Tuesday. But it's not just up to us lot. It's a job of able-bodied people to be good allies and to fight our fight with us. Because that's the thing about disability. It could happen to anybody at any time. You're fighting for a group you could belong to in the future, if you're lucky. Involve us, ask us, and stop speaking for us. Thank you.